What it do, gang? It's your boy, Warren G Body. And you know we up in the rock shop.
All right, gang.
Finally, the day is here. We're going to be dropping off this dry shaft, gang. Put the stock wheels back on. This is my Monte Carlo wheels. I put those back on. Got the front end down, resting on its own weight. And then we've got the rear end jacked up. But we've got it jacked up on the rear end. When you're trying to get your dry shaft measurement, you do not want to put the frame on the jack stands and let the rear end hang. You don't do that. It's okay if the car is like this. If it's the ass is way up like that, which is how we like it. It's okay. As long as the rear end is supported on the weight. You feel me? It's on its own weight. So, meaning that you have the rear end sitting on the jack stands. So, let's take a look. I think my battery about to die out. Yeah, so see how I got the rear end is on the jack stands right here? That's fine. I need it up high enough so I can take my measurement. And we're going to get on out there to, you know what I just thought about? This rear end's not going to be staying in here. Another 7.5 is coming in. But you know what? It'll be all right. If I got to get a recut, that's fine. And with that said, gang, let's say if you got three El Caminos that you're building side by side by side, and you got three dry shafts, the same combination, 700, 7.5, blah, blah, blah. You got to measure each El Camino. Don't measure one and assume the other two are going to be the same. Nope, don't do it. You got to measure each one. You feel me? That's what made me just think about that right now. Because I'm putting a different 7.5 in here. It's a stock 7.5, but it might be different. So just keep that in mind. If you're doing double bills, triple bills, whatever, you got to measure each one. So you can't go off of a buddy setting. You feel me? Maybe like a general area, but you got to make your measurements for each project. It might be different. You feel me? But yeah, gang, so we getting after that. Make sure I don't hit my head on nothing. We're getting after that today. We're going to head on out to Ed Moore's. That's who does all my dry shafts for me, gang. He did my original one I had cut down when he was alive for my SS. Oh, I thought it was down here. It's not. And they did the one for my El Camino, but that's cut for an 8.5. Remember, we're getting it cut for a 7.5 now, so I don't know where I put the other one at. But yeah, gang, Ed Moore's, that's where we headed to. Now, what I like to do is I like to make a whole sheet to show them right where I measured from. So from the flat portion on the yoke, I believe, right there, all the way up to the seal. Then I give them what the stick out is on the transmission. I let them know what card is, that the front wheels were on the ground, that the rear end was on jack stands. I give them as much information as I possibly can so that they can, you know, they know, okay, this guy, he took the measurements correctly. And then I'll measure it a few different times, gang, because I'm doing it by myself. You feel me? And another thing is, don't take your dry shaft and try to hold it in place and then take the measurement that way. Nope. Get you a tape measure. That was the hard part, was trying to hold the tape measure flat and true from this point right here and then going all the way back to that point right there. So if you got a buddy, best to get a buddy and help you out so you can hold that tape straight. You feel me? But yeah, gang, so we're going to head on out there, man. We're going to hit this road trip on out there to drop it off. And then hopefully he will get it back to me tomorrow. And I'm going to try to get all the footage of it, you know, me getting up there, you know, making the measurements, taking the measurements, dropping it off, going back to pick it up, getting back here to the shop, stabbing it in, and then going through the motions now of putting it in gear. Now, to get it in gear, I got to start putting all of this stuff back together. All this stuff's been chilling and waiting to go back in, and I think we got it. We got everything we need. We also got the spring washer that goes down in here with the bushing. We got that part. So I'm hoping this all pans out, gang. It works. You feel me? Because it would not work with a column shift on this car. That's why this car became a bench seat. Went from a bench seat to, you know, what it is now with the buckets and a floor shifter. You feel me? Because I couldn't get the 87. It kept hitting no matter what I did. But hers seemed to work out. I also have a little spacer. I checked the forms out, and I saw that one guy was moved everything to the other side, and I'll show you what I mean. And he used like a spacer, and I found this in my little parts bin. But yeah, gang, so we're going to get after it. Head on out there, get on back. This is not done yet. We got a lot to do. I just want to get it out the garage so I can free my man Elko Marcus's garage and get my Malibu here. So that's what we're going to be working on today. So, you know, hang tight, gang. We getting closer. All the little fine, intricate little stuff, you know, lining the panels up and all that, I can do that outside. Here, all the big work's been done, motors and transmission. We will be swapping out that 7.5 for a beefier 7.5. 373 gears, Posi, 28 spline axles, Moser axles. So that's why I want to swap it. But yeah, gang, so we can do that outside. That's easy to do out there. But we need the space for the Malibu. All right, y'all, fading it on out. We're going to hit this road soon, get on out there and drop this thing off, and hopefully we can get it back tomorrow and start the whole process. Yes, sir. All right, guys, we got to jack this up just a little bit higher. So climb up underneath there. All right, that should be high enough. All right, gang, I'm gonna get the, I'm actually gonna put the ones that lock. I'm gonna move these out. These my boy Dave gave to me. Shout out to Dave. This whole hookup he gave to me, man, when he got out the G-Body game. Bless me with a gang of parts, you feel me? But yeah, let me go ahead and swap these out so I can get the locking style up underneath there, and then I'll feel a little bit safer climbing up underneath there. All right, y'all, fading it out. All right, gang, we got it jacked up a little bit higher. Of course, I got it supported with my good floor jacks with the locking pins. And I got the floor jack on there. So I have this little plug, but once you put stuff down here, you can't find it. And I plugged the transmission right at the seal. I put this little cap on to keep any fluid from leaking out. But I couldn't find it, so what I did is I put the transmission in park, and I stabbed an old drive shaft in there so it wouldn't leak out, you feel me? So I don't know if it's going to leak out now when I pull that out, because it is full, and I'm going to climb up underneath here. Well, let me climb up underneath here, gang, and show you where you need to measure from, because a lot of people don't know. I mean, you can find all this stuff on you know, just do a Google search. So all right, you can see the drive shaft. I got some yelp. See that? That's the drive shaft. And right now, oops, I can't get to it. See where my finger is? I don't know if you can see. I can't even see right there. That is the seal right there where my finger's going back and forth. So you want to measure from this seal all the way back. Sorry, gang. You want to measure from that seal all the way back to right where that hole is. I can't get my other finger over there, gang. Let me see if I can. Right there where you see my finger tapping to the flat portion of this. That's what you want to measure from. You feel me? That's going to give you what they need. Then the other thing is, when you pull the dry shaft out, the dry shaft right here, when you pull the dry shaft out, let me bring this back around, gang. Sorry about this. When you pull the dry shaft out, right where that seal is, so let me get back over here. Right where that seal is, I don't know if you can see my finger, but right where that seal is, there's a spline, and that's what this is going into. That's what the slip yoke, I believe this is called, is going up into. It's going into, like, it's got 30 splines on it. Well, it has a stick out, and you need to measure that from the flat portion of here and how much of a stick out. I know this is a half inch stick out. Those are, and you need to let them know what your combination is, what your rear end is, all of that stuff. So let me get after that. So I'm gonna get me a little container ready just in case if something wants to come out of there. And it's gonna be a bitch because everything's in the way now. See, without all this stuff in the way, it was easier for me to get it. I'm pretty sure I got this setting, but I wrote it down somewhere and I couldn't find it. So now I gotta redo it. But all right, guys, so what I'm gonna do is, this is where having a tape measure with the magnet on it comes in handy. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to tape it to that seal and then pull it all the way back and measure it to that flat spot. And that'll be my measurement. I'll give them the stick out, the measurement, the rear end, and the transmission that I'm using. So a 700R4 350 combo, motor combo, 7.5 stock rear end, and then give them a stick out on the spline. Mine is a half inch, and then give them this measurement from that seal, that flat seal, all the way to the flat portion on the rear end right there. All right, y'all? All right, let's get it. All right, gang, so now that we got the dry shaft out, this is what I was talking about. Let me get my hand around there. This part that I was tapping on, that's the half-inch stick out. See the splines right there? I don't know if you can see that. I'm in a weird position. So I need to measure from this flat seal right here all the way up. I'm not sure if I'm in the area, but all the way up to the flat portion where you would mount the bolts at, right there on the yoke, all right? So that's what we're going to get after. I don't know if you can see anything down there. You can see my hand. So from here all the way over to there is what I'm going to get. And then that stick out. And I'll show you, see if I can manipulate the camera around. I don't know if you see my finger. With this, I'm not sure if it's showing it, but I can't see. That stick out right there. I think I can see a little bit of it. So that stick out right there is about a half inch. So yeah, gang, let me get after that. And I'll bring you guys back in. Yes, sir. It's a tight fit down here, but you got to get after it. You feel me? Yes, sir. All right, gang. So from right here, this flat portion right here, all the way up. I don't know if you can see that. So that flat portion right there. I don't know if it's showing because I can't see it. There we go. To that flat portion right there, I came up with like 60 and 3 quarters. Between 60 and a half and 60 and 3 quarters. It's hard to hold the tape completely flat, but that's where I'm coming in. I measured it like 10 different times and I kept coming up. I'd leave, I'd come back, I'd measure it again, and I kept coming up with that same number. So they'll know, you know, like if it's like way off, they'll be like, hey, yeah. Based off of the specs that I'm giving them. I'm giving them the transmission, the rear end, all that stuff. I'm giving them all that information, the year of car. All that stuff's real important that they know that. So they can be like, oh, okay, it's an El Camino. Oh, okay. They'll be like, hey, normally G-bodies don't. But oh, it's an El Camino. It's a different wheelbase. So you know what I mean? All that information is needed. So that's what I'm coming in at, like 60. And see, now that I've been away for a minute, I'm going to measure it one more time. You know, it's best to keep measuring it and cut, measure thrice, cut once. But yeah, gang, so let me go ahead and get that measurement one more again, and then I'm going to transfer all that information over to a piece of paper. And I usually draw it all out to make it as, they're professionals, you feel me? But I like to just give them as much information as possible. All right, y'all, fading it out. Fading it back in, gang. All right, I just got the call from Ed Moore. He says that Drive Lines, he said they are ready, but they're closing early today. So, gang, I'm going to head on up there. They called right when I was messing around with these motors. This is a new motor, but the polarity was flipped. Okay, the one I bought off of Amazon. So I didn't want to depin the harness. So what I did is I had another one sent out through 80s Performance. They sent the new one out, but they sent the new one out with the right side bracket. And so I was like, oh, what am I going to do? So I started looking at the bracket and I was like, well, I bet you the units are the same. It's just the bracket flips it. You feel me? And so I hit up Mel. Mel had actually already emailed him, and that's what the guy said. Also, my man Diaz, still standing over at Still Standing Garage, he hit me up on the gram and he said, "Hey, Warren, just go ahead and flip the bracket." And I was like, "Oh, okay, I was on the right page." So that's what I'm talking about, gang. The G-Body community comes to the rescue once again. Everybody is in different levels, stages of their builds. Some guys are building hella show cars. Some are just building street cruisers like how this one is. It ain't got to be perfect. The panels are going to be wavy. We not worried. But everybody respects everybody's build, and everybody wants to see each one of us out. You feel me? You guys go back and watch my videos and my playlist from when we started with this. And I'm telling you, you'll respect the build on this one because we saved her. This thing, 100% of people would have got rid of it. They would have, you know, tossed it. And we almost did. But I went Uncle James, the original owner. I said, "Man, you watching down. We going to save this old girl and bring her back to life." So shout out to my man, Diaz, still standing in the garage. Let's go. Bro got me right, told me what to do, and we hooked up now. So I got a whole bunch of different hardware and stuff, and so all I'm going to do is put a little Loctite on there. I got a lock washer, I got washers. We're going to put a little Loctite on there, and now we ready to go. All right, y'all, we're going to head on up here. I got the Silverado, the Rado ready to roll. Got her warming up, and we're going to head out there to get this dry shaft, stab it on in, and then we're going to hook up all this linkage. I hope this linkage plays fair, gang. It would not play fair when I did the 87. But on the mock-up, everything worked. And a couple of forum posts. A lot of you young brothers, man, y'all don't go to the forums. You feel me? The forums is where we used to hang out before social media, you know, took place. The forums, you know, had... If you needed to know stuff about hooking up sound systems, electrical, I mean, diagrams, everything is in the forum. So I went combing through the forums and found out how to make this work. The stock linkage work if you're running, you know, long tube headers. And that's what we got on here is long tubes. So what happens is when you go to shift, this, I believe this part right here hits the collector. So I ordered all new parts, gang. We got this is called a spring washer that goes in here, and this part connects to the proportioning valve, and then this part gets the spring washer. See, I also got another little spacer just in case. But the brother that put the post up, I appreciate the hell out of him. And even if it doesn't work, I'm gonna go back and thank him for putting that up. If you can still post, because sometimes they be able to post on the shit. My battery died. I was saying I was gonna go back and thank the bro for putting that post up. But yeah, gang, so there it is. We're gonna head on up there. Truck is warming up, and then when we get back, we'll finish up on this. Drop that motor in. Like I said, man, we be all over the place, gang. Drop that motor in and then test it, and I'm gonna get the windows and everything put back in today. We did a complete cleanup on this, gang. I mean, thoroughly cleaned it all down inside, blew everything out, put a little bit there. We're going to put some Dynamat on, new door pulls, the whole nine, gang. I'm sounding like my man Still Standing Garage. Rock Shop Garage, let's go. All right, gang, we back up here at Ed Moore's. Get this one unlocked. All right, it's going up in here, man. Y'all know what it is. We up here. Pick this thing up. I'll fade you guys back in at the shop. All right, gang, we back in. Now, these have the, yeah, see, it's got the little right there. They've already been greased up. They'll last forever. So we got the front, we got the rear, real clean. Yes, sir, thoroughly happy. I wish they would have painted the whole thing though, but it's all good. I'ma scuff it up and just paint it right quick. Actually, I don't even need to. I'll just clean it and spray some paint over top of it. It'll be all good. Yeah, gang, so wish me luck. We gonna fit this thing on up in here. Hopefully my measurements were correct. excuse me. And he says it's ready to roll. So we got a few things we got to do before we get that crack and get this stabbed in, put the linkage in so we can get it out of gear. Let's go, gang. Let's go. All right, gang. We got the drive shaft slipped right on in, gang. Yeah, so we're now getting all the steering linkage that I cleaned up. We got a new spring washer, some gaskets. These are like spacers. I might need them. I might not need them. I got a couple of washers I'm going to put. Basically, what this does, this sits down inside here. That sits down inside there. If I can get the damn thing out of here. I can't get the damn thing out. But yeah, gang, so what that does is it sits down in there like that. Then to keep that from getting chewed up, I'm going to run another washer. Then this will go like that. I'll put another washer on that side. And it all slips down just like that. See what I mean? Yeah. So that's what we're going to do. This fits on here like this. I'm trying to do this with one hand. You know how it is. So, no, I won't run a washer on that side. This will go like this. And that'll go like that. All right, that's how that all goes, I believe. Yeah. All right, gang, so I'm gonna have to go look at a couple of pictures I got saved of how all this goes back together. And then you got this right here, the rod. So we're gonna go ahead and get that hooked up. It's still early, so I'm hoping I got the wheels tightened down. I'm hoping I'll be able to get it in reverse. I could actually start it and click, click, because I don't have a neutral safety on here. And then I start it up and get the wheel suspending that way. But I'm going to go ahead and hook all the linkage up. You know I'm going to do it. All right, y'all. Let me get after it, and I'll bring you guys back on. Yes, sir. All right, gang. I'm going to let it warm up. I got everything put back together. I ran through the gears. I don't have in is a cotter pin for up top. I gotta get that in there. I need to slide it forward a little bit more. That might do it. Yeah, I need that cotter pin in there. I'm gonna let this idle down, and then we'll go ahead and give it a try. I got the wheels up. We'll see what it do. All right, gang. Fading it back on in, gang. Okay, I ran through the gears, and you know, I'm standing right here going through the gears. You already know what the problem is. Okay, so I go through the gears, I get it in, I go to reverse, I go to neutral, I go down to the next gear drive, and then I go back up, and right when I get to reverse, I hear bam, and I'm like, what the fuck is that? So I shut it down. I'm like, what the hell is that noise? Well, see, I hit one of my homeboys. I was like, man, what the hell is this noise? I made a video. He goes, ah, oh, knucklehead, you don't got your foot on the brake. You doing it from outside. And I went, oh, shit, the fucking rear end is still spinning. Yeah, you know how it is when you're excited, gang. But that's what it's all about. Nobody's clowning. We helping. The homie stepped in and was like, oh, big dog. Now, you know I'm going to mess with you. I'm going to mess with you, OG. You too excited. You got your outside. It's spinning. You're going back through. I went, yep, it's going this way. And all of a sudden, I'm throwing it in gear to go that way. So, yeah. But we also had to move the linkage over. I went looking. It's hitting this. Let me see if I can zoom in. See that right there? It's hitting that. And it's already done wore the paint off. And it's hot as hell. Yeah, so I'm going to see if I can shim this over, like about right there. Just like in the picture. So what I ended up doing is, there's this little spacer. And the pipe comes down, and the spacer and everything's on this side of the washer or of the bracket. What I did is I moved everything around and put it over here to move this way some, away from the header. In the picture I found, the guy had like a spacer about an inch long, and he moved it all the way away from the header. Now, the area that I was hitting when I had everything over here in this situation was right here. Make sure nothing gonna get me. Yeah, see, I got my little spacer right there. Now, the area that was hitting, gang, let me turn around. The area that was hitting yep, still hot, was right here. But see, look at all that space I got in there. So I'm good here. And what I ended up doing is, I don't know if it shows that. Yeah, see, I moved. This is supposed to go on this side, and the bolt goes on this side. It's like countersunk, and it fits up inside that hole, and the nut goes inside there. The bolt goes inside there. Right, like I said before, this is a spring washer. Yeah, it does that. But yeah, so what I ended up doing is moving everything on this side to try and move it away from the header. Now, the one guy, he actually had a spacer like that one right there in between. So it went, how'd he have it? He had a spacer in between this. So it moved this piece all the way over about right here, which moves it off the header. Now, he was hitting this whole piece, or something in here was hitting right here on the collector like how mine was. But yeah, so I'm gonna get a longer screw, and then that has an opening, a hole in it, so I can run the bolt through it. But right now, it's just barely tapping that header in this position, and I'm able to shift through all the gears. So yeah, what I'm gonna do now, gang, is I'm actually gonna go ahead and put some fluid up in the, put the gasket on there, put some fluid up in there and get that cracking. It's not posi, so this side don't spin. It's the other side that spins. I'll download the story off my Instagram, and because I don't want to keep going through the gears. Well, you know what? After my boy told me what was going on, I came in, I put it in reverse, and then I put my foot on the brake. I went out into neutral, and then I went into drive and no issues. Then I went from drive back to neutral with my foot on the brake, back to reverse, then into park, and the noise was done because it wasn't spinning anymore. But I barely got brakes because the brakes need to be bled and the booster is not hooked up. So, all right, gang, we're going to get after that. I'm pretty sure I have a gasket in here somewhere. Pretty sure of it. Where I put it, I don't know. I could have sworn I had it over here. No, I guess not, gang. My mirror be tripping peeps out. Yeah. I can't wait to get her actual exhaust on, gang, because this one has a loud exhaust leak. It be driving me crazy because I be thinking it's the, you know, something wrong with the car. I don't know where the hell I put. Oh, here it is, right here. So yeah, gang, I'm gonna go on ahead and hook this up. Put this one on, a little Felpro one. This rear end is not stained, but I'm not sure when we're gonna be able to, get the other one going. So what I'll do, gang, is, I almost tripped. What I'm gonna do is I'll go ahead and hook this all up, at least put a little bit of fluid in there. It's not like we're gonna go driving, but I can hear the gears as it's spinning. I can hear the gears doing some weird shit. So yeah, so okay, gang, we'll go ahead and fill this up, and I don't have to put the anti-chatter or none of that type of stuff because we don't have posi in this one, you feel me? So all right, let's fade it on out. I'm gonna get up underneath there, get my lights and everything set up, and then go on ahead and get the cover sealed up, and then put the fluid in. All right, y'all, fading it out. All right, gang, we back in. Pull all these out and try not to lose them. Cause you know, bolts are like 10 millimeters. They just come on missing, gang. So we gonna pull this cover off. Ain't nothing in it, gang. You can see how loose it is. We never put fluid in it, but what I want to do is I want to check that bolt to make sure, because I can't remember. It's been a long time, gang, so I can't remember if I put Loctite on there, so, and I can't even remember the size, so we're going to find out what that is, and then You feel me? And then pull it on off. So we got that much tight. All right, gang. So you see what it is. Let me get after it. I said ain't nothing up in here. The top one's tight also. All right. So we're going to cut all of them off. Got all of them off. And I'm going to go ahead and, yeah, those two are tight. All right. So let me get my ratchet set up and get that cracking, gang. And I'll bring you guys back on. I thought I had a leak on the brakes, but it was actually the condensation building up on that, coming down and dripping. Yeah, all right, gang, let's get, wait, that's the best fragrance in the whole world. All right, so that one right there looks like it's got a little blue on it, so I probably did. I'm not gonna be able to pull it all the way out. But there it is. So I'm just gonna make sure I got it torqued down, because we're not gonna be driving, gang. You're just gonna, you know, doing donuts and stuff with this rear end. We're gonna check the make sure it's tight, and then I'm gonna seal it all up and call it done. Yeah, all right, guys. All right. Young Marcus came through, gang. We got it cracking. She tucking. She shifting. And let's see if she's stopping. It might cut out. So Marcus, hold that for me. Let me know if it stops. I want to see if the brakes work. Brakes are working, gang. They're not working to, you know, it's working enough to where we can pull it out. It's shifting properly. I'm straight. Ah. All right, gang. Go ahead and shut it off. And we back in, gang. All right, y'all, I'm gonna call it a success. You got her started, you got her idling. Now it's time to tune it, you feel me? I believe with the carburetor setups, man, you wanna get it in gear and drive, and that's when you wanna set the idle, you feel me? Right now, just in idle, not in just in park, I got it set at about 720. Well, when you put it in drive, the RPMs drop all the way down. You see what I mean? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get it in drive, put my foot on the brake with some help, and then you know, have them dial up the RPMs a little bit and get it to about 720, about 800, which is going to maybe raise it up to 1,000. So, but yeah, gang, we saw it spin up. You heard some noises, and it was just stuff hitting. You know, we had the emergency brake. It was hitting the dry shaft. And we got some other stuff going on that we got to see what's happening. I didn't have the nut tightened down, so the distributor moved. So I got to get it back in that sweet spot, because I started hearing it pop off the back. And I was like, oh, that might be the timing, because it's all out of whack. But you see what it is, gang. Just little bitty stuff. We got the window regulator situated. Where'd it go? Shit, where'd I put it? But yeah, we got the window regulator situated, gang. I don't know where the hell I put it. I got it. The one they sent out, I said, oh man, they sent the right side out. But what it is, it's the bracket. You got to flip the bracket around. And so I drilled out the old bracket on both of them. On the first one they sent me out that was bad, I drilled that bracket out, drilled out the new bracket, and then swapped them, and now we good to go. Oh, you know what? It's already down inside there. But yeah, gang,
So we got that done. Tomorrow when I get up, I'm gonna start working on the windows, getting those windows back in there and plugging up everything. I don't think I got the vacuum line. Yeah, I don't got the vacuum lines not hooked up. The brake booster is not hooked up. And just a few things, gang, and we getting closer. Shit, man, it's your little homie up in the rock shop doing what we like to do best, rep 80s, and most definitely keep it Chevy.